My dermatologist recommended that I try a new treatment, which was reported in 2020, for various types of porokeratosis, including DSAP. I've had DSAP for a long time. The reference to the procedure is at the bottom of the slide. This video shows how I did cream treatment with occlusion for this procedure. The supplies I used are shown here. The cream is a 2% cholesterol, 2% lovastatin cream from a compounding pharmacy. Buying it by the pound is probably cheaper than in smaller quantities, and with the amounts I used for both arms and legs, I went through a pound in 2 weeks. The other items from left to right are a plate, plastic spoons, sandwich bags, vinyl gloves, tetranet, plastic wrap, tape, scissors, and some cloth. You'll see what I used the cloth pieces for in a couple minutes. This part is optional, but I like to weigh out the cream at least once so I know how much I'm using. I use a kitchen scale with a plate and a baggie on top of it with the long side up. Get my plastic spoon. I'm aiming for about 13 to 15 grams. Okay, good eye. Now I'm going to apply the cream using a hand that's inside a baggie. I'm going to do my lower leg all the way up to the knee. This is a field treatment, so I'm going to do the whole thing up to the knee, front and back. You may not be doing a field treatment. You may only be doing parts that have spots, but I'm just doing it all over for the moment. Putting a little bit more in the area where there are more spots. Other leg. I have a considerable number of spots on the back here. And the two arms. I'm going to do the arms also below the elbow. But on the arms, I'm only doing the parts that tend to be full of the spots. Not the soft underbelly. I'm also doing the back of the hand here because I have some issues with that as well. But I'm not doing the part here, the piece that is more sensitive. Now I have to switch hands. Do the other one. Now I have just a little bit left of the amount I had actually dispensed in the beginning. I'm going to go back and make sure I've gotten the back of the hand, which tends to be rubbed off a little bit. And then I use what's left on the baggie to touch up any spots that I see could use a little bit more. So that took care of the 13 grams that I weighed out earlier. And if I do a wrapping with the cream of the cream with a plastic wrap right away, I tend to end up with a rash. So I'm going to let it dry and sink in for 15 minutes to a half hour so that I can prevent that. So this is a good time to eat breakfast. Now for the occlusion part, also known as wrapping yourself up in plastic. You can see that the cream has sunk in pretty well. I'm going to start, though, with putting gloves on so that I don't rub it off the back of my hands as I work. I like having the fingers out of the gloves. That's just a personal preference. So now I take the saran wrap or the plastic wrap and start on the leg. Just wrap it around any old way. That leg's done. That leg's done. The arms are a little trickier. One thing I do with the arms is to try to protect that sensitive area. For some reason in the plastic, it makes my arms feel like they're getting a rash. So what I do is I cut a piece of an old pillowcase so that it is about the area of the sensitive part of my arm. And I'm going to tape it on there so that the plastic isn't actually up against my arm in that area. So I tape it to my glove. I line it up so that I have all of the spots exposed, but the sensitive area is covered. Then I just lay it on the plastic. I must admit, this works better with a buddy, but my buddy happens to not be here right now, so I'll just survive getting it done this way. Then I do the other arm, which is harder because I'm right-handed, keeping the spots exposed to the plastic, but the delicate part not. Thank you. Now, to make sure that it will stay on, I use this Tetranet. I like it. It's available online. I have a size 4. You don't have to use Tetranet. You can do something else. I used to use leg warmers from my dance days, and on the arms, an old sock that I cut the foot off of, and I can just put that on my arm. That fits up here to hold it on. But here's the Tetranet, and it looks like it would never make it, but it stretches a lot. So you stretch, 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 get through. Put it over the hand. This actually will go over the leg as well. It just stretches, has to stretch even more. And you can use these over again, since they're really not contacting the cream or anything. So I have been doing that, and they work pretty well. Even when I went out on a 7-mile hike, it stayed up. It was hot, but it stayed up. Nice and neat, cute. I can do the other arm, but I'll just show you the leg. I'm going to use one of the ones that I have used before. It's already stretched, you can see, but this is actually the same Tetranet. All done. So now I'm ready for the day. I'll do the other leg after I finish the video, but I'm ready for the day, and it's all nice and cozy. Good luck with it.